Hello everyone and welcome to the 9th episode of my Devlog series about the development of a simulation game called Leah. In case you didn't know, Lost in Athilidus is an indie game about a fantasy land where you can build, design and manage your own town. It is an isometric game set up in Unity 2D. In this episode you will see a new building in town, the library. I will show you how I make my gorgeous houses for the game using free assets and Photoshop. Another thing for this episode is the new building movement in the editing mode. It is still grid-based, but so smooth now. And the library building will bring us to a new activity in the game – crafting. It is still in development, but I want to show you the beginning. By the way, I'm going to release a new tutorial soon about how to make a grid-based building system, so subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on, so you won't miss it. And let's get started. The first thing I made this week was the building for my library. You can watch another episode where I went through the process of making a new building. As I usually do, I put the new house next to the ones that I already made. I already applied the same filters that I used for the previous buildings. This includes brightness and contrast, saturation and green hue. But as you can tell, this does not do the trick completely. Each building is different and has to be adjusted according to its color palette. I am adding some yellow brush strokes to create some texture on the walls. The key here is to add some imperfections to the house to make it seem less graphic. Also, I couldn't decide what roof I want to make. I wanted some diversity in my game. I tried smudging the lines, but that didn't work. Then I found a roof texture, though it looks more like fish scales. But the point is, I like this one. This is what I ended up with. I added a book onto the building, since it is a library, but because it is small, you can hardly tell that it is a book. It looks more like a colorful window, but it makes the library look good. When I put my building into the game, I ran into a problem with path generation. It would only appear if the library was in a certain position on the map. Otherwise, the path would not be generated. I immediately assumed that it had something to do with the fact that I didn't consider that a building can face the right direction. Previously, they had all been turned to the left. I did some debugging, but I wouldn't call it so because I didn't use a debugger itself. I was coloring the tiles through code to see how the path generation works inside. After a long process of developing multiple if statements to cover all the possible options, the system worked well. This week I made an important adjustment in the building movement in the editing mode. Previously, it was really uncomfortable. On PC, the building would just jump to another point where you click. On mobile, the situation was better, but still not perfect. I had some drag mechanic, but because of the grid, it was edgy. So, my goal was to come up with a solution that fits both PC and mobile. The new movement system works with methods on mouse down, where it saves an offset from the center of the house to the clicked position on it, on mouse drag, where it moves the building to where the mouse is, and on mouse up, where the building snaps to the nearest grid position. After fixing the movement, I got back to developing my library. I made a window for it with slots for player's inventory, crafting slots and a display for the resulting item. Quickly followed a tutorial on drag and drop from CodeMonkey and tested it in the game. Now it was time to add some functionality to this window. Originally, I thought that I would have multiple buildings with crafting activity, so I created one script for all of them. But then I realized that this is not the best option, because I wanted a different window and functionality for each of them, so I renamed the script to just library. The reason I chose library as a crafting building is that I found an awesome asset pack with RPG book icons, which I absolutely had to use in my game. So, I arranged them all on one canvas and started sorting and dividing them into crafting chains, which combination produces which item. When I went back into Unity, I did some modifications to my drag and drop system, and now it had more functionality than I wanted. First, the inventory is initialized after the window is opened. Also, I wanted to make it possible to rearrange the items, but the order is not saved, so it still needs some work. Then, I got to the crafting mechanic. In a nutshell, to make a crafting system, you need two scriptable objects, a craft item and a craft recipe, which holds a list of ingredients and a result. In the code, I detect when the crafting slots are filled with items, and if a recipe with those items exists, I set the result icon and the button active. I spent a lot of time dealing with one silly mistake. Each time I crafted, crafting function got called more and more times. I checked everything, and I couldn't find how it can be called so many times, when I only call it once in my code. But then I figured out that I was adding a new listener to the craft button, each time I set it active. And this is how the game looks now. There is a new building in town, library, which you can move smoothly thanks to my new system. I am so satisfied with the way it turned out that I installed the game on my phone and sometimes I go there just to move the buildings around. Now we have a new mechanic in the game, crafting. It still needs some polish because, for example, I haven't figured out where the player would get these books and where they would be useful. I think I forgot to mention that this system was not part of my original plan. I just wanted to see these beautiful book images. They add even more magic to this game. And this is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel to see weekly updates on this game. Bye!